Chris Smith, who's the author of the House Bill.
Chris, well, hi.
How are you? Nice to see you.
Well, nice to see you.
I'm enjoying it.
Have a signing.
Yeah. It's a good issue.
Mr. President.
Look at you.
Mary Gall, who's the chairman of the Task Force on Adoption, and her two children.
Mr. President, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Mrs. Walter and Rosita.
Hello, Rosita.
Say hello. It's very nice to meet you, sir.
Sure.
How are you?
Larry Bonnell, Jonathan.
My wife, Regina.
Hi.
Hello, Larry. I'm just going to see the camera. So you don't do it that
way. Yeah, I know.
All right.
Are you scared? How do you do? I'm Jackie Haas. This is my son, Rob.
Hello there.
My husband, Kim.
Hello.
Nice to meet you. I'm so excited.
Nice to see you.
Come on,
Dad. He said he was nervous about me
here.
Okay, let's go over here. Taylor, Ryan, Sean, she. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Yeah, yes, sir.
I'm sweating. Run around.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah.
Thanks, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now I guess the other
time. That's going to help us get organized before we bring the press in. Mr. President, Lisa. Should we just give them a part of the website? Okay, get it close.
Families organize, then we'll bring the press in.
Okay? Get over a little bit this way. And
a little bit more to your right.
Okay, terrific. Okay,
Jim. Oh, don't worry about it.
Mom,
I'm silent. Okay, be shy.
This is the thing that makes it fit.
Thank you so much.
Thanks again.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. It's really
really an honor to meet you.
Thank you. Good luck with this administration.
Okay. Mommy.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Appreciate it. Okay. You're awesome. Very good. Well,
President,
thank you.
One last quick point out. I'm very happy for life. Thank you.
What?
In the right to life. We thank you for your good work. It's made a difference.
No.
Okay, come on, get behind
you. Okay, let's go this way. Thank you very much.
Mommy, is this weekend?
Yes, sir.
What's
up, man?
What is it with weather?
Okay.
Tommy Hurt.
Hi, how are you?
Pleasure to meet you. I've been waiting for so long to get this opportunity to meet you now, and it's happened. I'm very, very proud.
Well, I'm glad.
Thanks for having me here.
Thank you. Champion in 4 weight divisions. Yeah. That has never happened before.
No, this is something
you're the first.
Bit different for me, but I'm feeling very, very great about it. To be able to see something like this that I know that people have went out, that we have 3 or 4 other people that went out to try to exceed it, but have not been as fortunate as I have.
Well, if I have it right, it's junior welterweight,
light heavy, middleweight. Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
And you're known as the hitman.
Yes, sir.
Now, you know, If you ever get pictures, I used to do a few fights, but it was always in motion pictures.
Well, if I do decide I want to get into pictures, I know who to come and see. You give me a few pointers.
Yeah, because for one thing, I'd give you a pointer now.
Okay.
Yeah. Some of the best blows you never hit.
Okay.
You're trained to
do
hit.
Do I see them?
You got to miss.
Oh, okay.
And the way we did it in pictures was, well, I think we did maybe set the camera up.
Should I just square off a little bit and have like that?
But don't reflexively hit back.
Okay.
And then you leave your hand a little loose, so if you did have an accident and hit the person, it wouldn't be as damaging as with a tight fist.
Okay. Now, I have had those before, but sometimes they slip. So what do you do in the matter when it slips?
Well,
you retaliate, right?
I can tell you that. Then, if you remember, when my hand goes by there, you let your head go back as if I hit you.
Okay, let's try.
And I, in the dubbing room, they dub that in.
Oh, all right.
And you think you're going to hit. But you mentioned something. Usually they would have, if I was in the scene and for the fighting myself for the other actor, they get a stuntman. Mm-hmm. But that would be then when they were shooting on my direction,
right.
So back of the head, so they wouldn't know that they were on the other. And one day, accidentally, I did clip him. Been working all day on this fight.
Did you hurt him?
Huh?
Did you hurt him?
You knocked him out.
Okay. That's what I want to hear. Those are the types I want to hear. You would have hurt him.
2 weeks later, coming to the finish of the picture, there was another fight scene with another actor in this particular picture, and another stuntman, of course. And as we were standing there, I told him, I said, boy, I hope you're waiting for the camera to roll and get the scene. And I said, I hope, you know, that I don't do what I did. And I told him what I've done a couple of weeks, because I know he's my roommate. And just before the final shot in the picture, in this fight scene, I ended up with a closed eye. But he waited till the end so we wouldn't lose any time filming. The picture was over then.
That's great. Thank you for
taking
the
time.
I appreciate it.
Thank you. Gordon
Bart McClendon. Mr. President, I represent the World Boxing Council, sir. What a pleasure. What a great pleasure. My reflexes are not nearly as good as yours.
Steve Crossen,
Mr. President. Hello. Nice to see you, sir. Good to see you. Thank you very much.
Emmanuel Stewart.
Yes. Hello.
How you doing?
Good to see you.
Daniel Kuhn, Mr. President.
Yes.
Mr. President, this belt is normally given only to world champions in the ring, but you've certainly demonstrated that you're a world champion in another arena, and so on behalf of the World Boxing Council, we'd like for you to have this world championship belt.
You mean just for a fake kick?
Those count too. Oh,
listen, thank you very much.
You're quite welcome.
I treasure this, and I have a hunch it may find its way into the Presidential Library.
Beautiful, fantastic.
Thank you very much. That's great. I have few little just souvenirs here for you, gentlemen. Souvenirs of it.
Well, thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. How's that?
I want you in a fake fight there. Be the his one you said.
I'll make sure I watch it. I'll make sure you. I'll assure you, I won't get knocked out.
I think we should keep that on hand, and I'll wear it when I go up to the hill.
Yeah, there you go. Hey, you got anything that'll go with?
All right. Sure. And Louise has a question for you also.
Okay. But you need a little bit of time to do the lighting, don't you, first?
Just a minute. Right. Do you have...
Mr. President, you've been looking at these sculptures a long time. What do you think of them? Do you enjoy it?
Well, yes, very much so. In fact, if you look around the other part of the room, you can see the...
Wait a minute.
That's...
Well, these were only to me by Annenberg. This is an artist that did these, and it is the history of the Western saddle, and up to the present, from starting clear back with about a 1540 Spanish war saddle, which was the origin of the Western saddle. And these up here are mine. And a little interesting thing here. You see these two fighters over here?
Yeah.
This Charles Russell always carried some lamps with him. He was at the training camp out in Montana when Jack Dempsey was training for a fight there. And his friend Jimmy Cagney was with him. And sitting there, he, with the wax, made that. And then gave it to Jimmy Cagney. And Jimmy had it in Hollywood for years under a glass dome. And a friend just kept after him and said, Jimmy, someday somebody could drop that and it'd be gone forever. He should have it put into bronze. It's a Charles Russell. And so Jimmy did. And when he finally gave in and did that, he had 16 of them made for family. A few friends, and I was one of the friends, and so there's only 16 of those.
Yes.
But that's a Charles Russell also.
So in your personal collection, you have Charles Russell.
Well, I've got one of the,
but what
one
do you...
of those out at the ranch house also. That's the sculpture. These are in here, mine, and some of these are gifts that have been given to me since. Those are mine.
I've been told that you always tell people to buy Western art, but you've never bought it yourself. Is that correct?
In the period when, what do I want to call it, the abstract art was so hot and people paying thousands of dollars for somebody that just painted a flag or something, I was always saying, you know, there was no real big thing for Western art. And I was talking about that Western art would come back because it was so great and so real and all of this. And it sure enough did. And then I had to recognize and realize that all the time I was doing the talking, I never bought a single piece of Western art. When, believe it or not, you could have had them quite inexpensively at that time. And suddenly things that I'd walked by and never thought of buying for myself turned out to be with thousands and thousands of dollars.
Very good.
Now, Mr. Russell, if you can just look at your papers and so on, but be around this thing.
Do you ever contemplate art by your window? Or contemplate your work by the art?
I'm always aware of them. I always see them. That, incidentally, was loaned to me by Matt Baldrige. That belongs to him. When I read it, I'll see if Mrs. Baldrige gets it back.
I understand you, but you used to advise your friends to buy Western art. Is that
I was just telling you the answer. Back when there was a lot of this, before it was And I used to be predicting that we'd come back and everybody got abstract out of their mind. And all the time I was saying that and talking about it, I never thought.
Do you, does Remington...
Yeah,
I'm a fan.
Do you think Remington is different than any of these other Western artists that you like in any way?
There are many fine Western artists, but no doubt he is one of the greatest. The matter of fact, Western aficionados say that you first should look at the horse's legs in Western art. That is the hardest thing to get. Only the great artists really get it.
Isn't that interesting?
It's a kind of a complicated thing, of course. You know, it bends. It bends back the other way here, and here bends up and so forth.
Remington always said that he knew a horse well.
Yes.
Do you think that's true? Did he know?
Yes. Yeah. That's one of the great features of it. See, look in the head. Way down.
Yeah. It's wonderful.
You never confronted a rabbit skeptical riding, I hope.
Yes, I have. And I've gotten down and killed a couple.
Oh, yeah. Did you scare them in the driveway when you got them back to the house?
Yes, whether you skinned them in the driveway when you went back to the house.
No, I never skinned anything, but I always knew enough to know that I didn't let them lay. I buried the head and put a rock on top of it. So that somebody couldn't accidentally step on it.
You never had this happen to you, so.
Well, almost. And the horse that's not long dead, but the thoroughbred red hunter that I was riding. And he wanted to take off. Well, it hit the dog that was riding or running along with us on the chest over by a bush, and I didn't see it or anything, and I heard the rattle of the horse. So the dog turned and came out of there, and I knew it had bit me just as And then I discovered something about those characters there. I went over thinking that I could hear it better. I couldn't see him, I couldn't find him in this bush. And I turned around. And when I turned around, it seemed as if it was, now the noise was coming from here. And then, in other words, they're kind of like a ventriloquist. So it just was coming from all around. And when I finally found it, it was right there where I had been found right in front of me. And I saved the dog and I...
Oh, the dog's in the house.
Yeah.
No.
I rushed him to a vet and said, what do I do now? And the vet says, why don't you come back in the morning when he's still alive? And you take him home, and if he isn't, why? He said that he was still alive. I'd give him a shot.
This was on your ranch?
Yeah. My most interesting time, not with a horse around. I ride a high horse, not Western. I ride cavalry style English. And so it would be very brave if I was on. So a couple of times without being able to get a rock or anything, I stomped on a snake's hip with my heel. I know he can't bite through those boots. One day, Bob Taylor and I were doing a little tin can shooting down in the woods with 22s. And his son came running over and said, snake, snake. And we followed him back, and sure enough, it was a raptor. And he was trying to make his way into the rocks to get away. And I looked for a rock to throw at him. I couldn't find one, so I stomped on his head. And then looked down and discovered I was wearing sneakers. I think about that sometimes in the dark of night, if I'd missed.
Oh, my
gosh. I just was so used to the other way.
Yes.
It wasn't until I was looking down, and there it was, just that canvas sneaker that killed the snake. And Charles Russell was great, of course.
Yes.
I I won't be able to get out with this under my coat. It belongs to the White House.
You have no personal reference.
Oh, yes. Sure. We've got the photo for the magazine.
I have come on this one here at the ranch.
You do the Bronco Buster?
Yeah. Oh.
Of your very, is this your own personal
copy? No.
In your collection?
Yeah.
Show us, please.
I don't have it.
We're going to do a group photo
collection.
Do you want to get maybe the two of you on this side?
Sure.
And
one person closer?
Yeah. Great.
Do you know my father, Peter, that this is a funny subject for his house?
When I was doing that interview, Clearfield.
Yes,
I know somebody. Once I heard a couple of guys talking, they said it was a shop in Hollywood, had a sculpture in the window for 1,200. And I never, I let it go by. And then,
we always think, well, tomorrow.
Yeah.
Thank you, Bill.
Sure. Well, good to see you all.
Can we have all our stuff?
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You know John?
Hello, Mr. President. Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Hello.
Mr.
Baker?
Hello, Sam.
Well, hello there, leader.
How are you, sir?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good
to see
you.
How are you?
Well,
how
are
you? See
you.
Hello, John.
How are you?
How's the knee?
Fine. Improving.
No crutch, no cast.
Well, I left the crutch out there. Cane that I'm working on. I was attending the races, Mr. President, and giving a trophy to the winning horse. And I stepped down and I was shaking a few hands with the crowd, and a little 6-year-old kid jumped in a vehicle and rammed it straight into the crowd, knocked me down, busted my
tree.
Public appearance. Public appearance.
Last time I was at a horse show, Mr. President, it was in Columbia, Tennessee, and I was to give the cup to the winner of the horse show, and the horse bit me.
That's
one of the great humiliations of my political career.
I think it's more political to get bit by a horse than get run over by a golf
ball.
Well, listen, thank you both for coming down, and thank you also for getting Frank's situation up there for confirmation as quickly as you have. And now, if there's any problem, and you think there's any problem, you might need somebody to telephone a few of your cohorts. Just let me know.
I think by 10:30 we'll have a new section.
I tell you, if we have a problem this morning, we'll call you. But we start at 9:30, and we ought to be through at 10:30. We have what they call the Senate unanimous consent, so nobody can interfere with the vote on it. And we think we've got 51 votes.
we've offered to have the vice president chair.
Well, and also I'm very pleased to
President.
Yes.
Prime Minister.
Yes. Prime Minister. Hello there. I'm glad to see you.
Happy to see you.
Happy.
How is Miss Sagan?
Just fine.
Glad to hear you.
All right.
And Ambassador,
you know,
have Sagan.
See you.
President
Long. Well, come in.
Thank you.
You've been in that chair before.
Yes.
We'll have a few minutes of pictures looking here, but you're going to get impressed with all that, right?
I don't know. Thank you.
I know it's a cloud of shirts up here.
Irish,
we're out of the
Irish,
Yeah, definitely. I enjoy it.
Tango.
Thank you.